Hello everyone, welcome to Romesh's Bird Sanctuary. I've been spreading the bread out a little bit further than I was before, so I'm now getting parrots coming right around this side, and I'm slowly leading them down to my back garden. They do come here sometimes, but this is what I'm... there's not much shade. Well, there's shade underneath there, of course. And these are rainforest birds, these rainbow lorikeets. So I'm... I just planted this tree. This is another of the poinciana trees. The beautiful red flowers, orange flowers. And this is another poinciana tree. This is actually about 3 years old. It's just small because it's been in a pot. And this is the part of my irrigation system that I've done. And this is the reward. I left this, I found this branch of a arelia tree, or known as the frangipani, or temple flower. And I found it on the ground on the nature strip. And I just brought it and leant it against the ground and against my wall. So birds will land on it. And 2 days ago when I came and looked at it, I noticed these. Yes, it's come to life. And it would take a frangipani tree many years to grow to this size. And yes, I've got a ready-made frangipani tree. A big one. And this is a little one that I planted. This is about, I planted this about 6-7 months ago. And it started flowering. And this is where I'm growing the small number of vegetables that I've got. I'm mainly interested in breeding animals rather than growing vegetables. And animals includes birds, of course. But I've got a lot of other animals that live here. There are a number of species of rodent, including eastern chestnut mice. And throughout the night, there's this beautiful rainforest sound of frogs, lots of different species of frog that breed in the water that I'm having flow gently through my property. And to keep the water flowing gently through the property, I run my taps much more than the Brisbane average. And that way I've got little pools of water that are not stagnant. Because if they're stagnant, they breed mosquitoes. So I'm running the water just slowly. Sometimes I turn it up a bit. And those are my noisy miners. And that there is a Tarisian crow that makes them alarmed. So this is another frangipani tree, or arelia. And underneath there I planted my daughter's placenta. It's a Greek tradition to plant the placenta and plant a tree over it. And this is a sacred tree for Buddhists. And some of my ancestors were Buddhists, some of my ancestors were Hindu. And this is a banyan tree, a type of fig, which is a sacred tree for Hindus. And it was actually started off as a bonsai that Zoe's mother Sarah gave me. And I planted it in the ground, and it's doing very well. Because this is the main area that I've been irrigating. This is where I started my irrigation system from. And I had a lot of opposition to this from the council and from my neighbors. They didn't understand what I was trying to do, you see. And I did this all with my my feet and my hands and a spade. I didn't use any machinery. And I've got various treasures here for children to learn about geology. And dinosaurs, like this for example, is copper ore. Well, it's golden like that. It's also known as peacock ore. Except that it's not red. That's a fossil in the lump of limestone. And yes, I've got various treasures over here. And these are places for my daughter to play. And for anyone else who wants to play with these things, I'm trying to make it as safe as possible by getting rid of sharp objects so that you can walk around barefoot. The whole idea is to walk around barefoot. As you can see, I have quite a few birds every morning. This is only about 5 o'clock in the morning, a bit past five. These are my rainbow lorikeets. It's a mixed flock though. It's not just rainbow lorikeets, there are noisy miners, like that one there. And there are blue-faced honey eaters, and there are some scaly-breasted lorikeets. And they all fly together in various ways. And they talk to each other, and they respond to each other's alarm calls, and friendship calls, but they don't respond to each other's courtship calls. The courtship calls are in behavior are species specific. BDI stands for Black Diamond Images. It's my photographic company. So as you can see, I've been making perches for them to settle, and wonderful way to study their behavior using a video camera. And birds love playing. Very social. These birds are mainly insectivorous. Well, I don't know about mainly. They are insectivorous, so I've seen them catching insects very adroitly with their on the wing. These birds are becoming tamer and tamer. They still maintain a healthy respect for me, and if I do something very surprising, they sometimes fly away in alarm. But yesterday I was playing my djembe drums quite loud on the right here on the front, and that didn't worry them in the least. I can sneeze, I can cough, and they don't fly away. If I run, they will fly. So if you're trying to observe birds, it's a good idea not to run, because birds get alarmed by people who are running. So you move slowly, in other words. And that's very good for relaxation. I do think that bird watching is a very, very healing pastime. So this is my little contribution to the healing of Australia. This is a male scrub turkey, which makes the noisy miners rather alarmed, partly because he runs. They run really fast, scrub turkeys, That one's actually got a broken leg, recovered from a broken leg. You can see a big injury, which is a very big deal for a scrub turkey, because that's how they get around. And I'm just going to show you my, now that I've had the water flowing, I'll show you my little irrigation system. Basically the water flows down there into a helmet shell, and that gives it a beautiful sound. And flows down here. These are Venus flytraps, and it flows down here. And I've got, these are my frog breeding ponds. This one is empty, it'll fill up. This one, there's a little pond in here that's got a bit of water in it already. And the frog spawn is laid by the frogs up here, and it flows down through here, down there, and over there you can see the frog spawn. Those little bubbles there. Yeah, that's frog spawn. So the tadpoles hatch out down here. There's a little very shallow pond in there. And this is another pond. This will get tadpoles. All I have to do is just keep the water running slowly. And the way that I monitor that there's not too much water is this point down here. And you can see that there's water collected here. Earlier on I had the water flowing through into my neighbors. But if you look at the actual outflow from the land, there's no water being lost in the stormwater drain. The sewerage drain, that also contains my indoor house water from the taps, and that's the stormwater drain. Now I'm not sure what's going on with the pipe, because this one goes in that direction, this one flows in this direction, and I have a feeling that some unusual plumbing was done before I moved in here, and that people have been stealing water, and actually stealing sewerage, something like that. But I know that the sewerage system was completely blocked up, because a year and a half ago there was sewerage flowing up here, through here. So I've cleaned that out by running water through my taps. So that sewerage is gone into the garden, and it's made it very lush, because of course sewerage is very good fertilizer, as long as it's used correctly. So what I've been doing is basically detoxifying my land with water, and the result is that it's a healthy house and healthy land with some very, very healthy birds, and lots of them. So that's my I got a letter back from the mayor wishing me luck for my environmental regeneration project. And yes, this is it, my Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary and the Hub Mini Zoological Gardens. Yeah, it's it's a paradise. That's what I think. As far as I'm concerned, I have created a paradise from a toxic, polluted piece of land with a toxic, polluted house. And you can walk around here barefoot, and I'm calling this architectural technique Cosmopolitan Green Architecture. It's one of my little cottage industries, CGA. Cosmopolitan Green Architecture. And these are very cosmopolitan green parrots. Yeah, so I'm going to let you watch my other clips about Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary, if you feel that way inclined. And you can also come and visit me. You find me right around over there, if you're more used to seeing the world upside down. That's where I am, in Brisbane. And you can get a GPS location. I provided the details, so do come and visit and see the miracle of Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary for yourself. And thanks for watching my YouTube.